series and parallel connections of cells. So like the resistors, these cells also can be connected in series or parallel, or you can combine them, you know, in one circuit you can have parallel and series combination both. So when cells are in series, suppose we have two cells, say we have first having EMF E1, second having EMF E2, and the internal resistance of this cell is say R1 and this is R2. They are connected in series, that is the current passing through both of them are same. So an external resistance, this external resistance R, is also connected across the connection. So we will apply the Kirchhoff rule. So if we say the current, because current will take this direction, right, and will move in the ABCDA direction, means ABCDA. So when we go here, it is coming, see, it is from higher to lower. So we will get this E1 in negative. We are going from higher potentials to lower potentials, so we have to take negative. And because we are moving in opposite direction to the current, so this will be positive, right, I into R1. Then again, for the same reason, this will be minus E2. And we are move for this one, we are moving in the opposite direction of current, so we have to take plus I into R2. That is, there will be voltage up, not drop. And as we are moving in the opposite direction of this I into R, again, this has to be IR. And this whole will be equal to zero. In a closed loop, the voltage or the potential difference between the same point, if you take a loop, it will be zero. So take E1 and E2 on this side, take I common. So I will be equal to E1 plus E2 by R plus small r1 plus R2. So what we have got here is, this is the equivalent EMF and this is the equivalent resistance, internal resistance, and I is the current which is passing through the resistor. So this series combination of two cells, this act as a single cell. So if you combine two cells in series, the equivalent, you can assume it to be a single cell, E1 plus E2. And internal resistance, this has R1, this is R2. So you can also say that the equivalent resistance is R. So in this sense, E equivalent is equal to you can say E equivalent is equivalent EMF, and R equivalent is the equivalent resistance if you connect the cells in the series. But if the polarity of one of the cells is reversed, then the EMF will be E1 minus E2. But the equivalent resistance, internal resistance, will not change. It will be R1 plus R2 only. Means if you combine like this, this is E1, this is E2, the resultant will be E1 minus E2. Okay, and the modulus of this. But resistance R1, R2, because resistance is already there, always there. For current, if current is passing, the resistance will be there itself. So R1 plus R2 will remain as, whether you connect it like this or in this similar polarity or in opposite polarity. Now the cells, when we put it in parallel. So this is one cell, this is two cell, and this is, these are kept in parallel, and we have a outer resistance, right? So suppose we have two cells, this is having E1 and E2 are the EMFs, internal resistance is R1 and R2. The current is like this. See, if you see I is passing through like this, then I will divide into I1 and I2, and I1 will pass through this, I2 will pass through this. So we want to find the current which is flowing through this external resistor. So we'll apply the Kirchhoff rule easily, because we know that I will be equivalent to I1 plus I2, right? And this will be our first equation. Now we can apply the Kirchhoff second rule for two loops. First will be this is A, D, and R, and C, and B, and first we'll take this E1, right? Means this will be our first loop. And then we have second loop, A, D, R, C, B. Now this loop we are going to take, this loop. So two loops we are going to take. So first we'll apply the Kirchhoff law to the first loop. So there will be, we are moving in the direction of current. Okay, so this is, let us start from here. we are moving in the direction of current, so we'll be I into R voltage drop. Then we are coming here. I1 is, we are in the direction of current, so I1 R1 will be voltage drop, so minus I1 R1. For this, we had already taken this. And since we are going from negative to positive, there is increase in the potential. So it will be plus E1 and this will be equivalent to 0. Similarly, for the other one also, we'll find out the same scenario, but here we will take E2. And from this, if you see, if we take I1, if you want to find I1, we take all other things on the right hand side, we get I1 equal to E1 minus IR1, IR by R1. For the second one, we get I2 equal to, similarly, this is replaced by E2, IR by, this will be replaced by R2. So we have I1 and I2. Now, the first equation was what? I was equal to, this I is equal to I1 plus I2. So I was equal to I1 plus I2. Let us put I1 and I2, we just found on in the previous discussion. That means this I1 and this I2 we have to put. So when you put it here and just rearrange them, right? We just need to rearrange in order to find I. So I will be equal to, this will be the final reason. Fine. So it will be I equal to E1 R2 plus E2 R1 by R1 plus R2 plus R1 R2. We are just rearranging it. So what we get? When we divide the numerator and denominator, we have this R1 plus R2. So we can just divide numerator and denominator by R1 plus R2. So we can divide this and we get this as the equivalent EMF R plus, and this is our equivalent resistance when they are in parallel. Please understand, we are talking about parallel. When the resistances are in parallel, that means you get 1 by R equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 like this. So in the parallel combination of cells, it acts as a single cell whose EMF is given by this E equivalent is given by this whole value. So it is E1 R1 plus E2 R2 by R1 plus R2. And what will be the internal resistance? Internal resistance is given by R1 R2 R1 plus R2. Because we know that R equivalent, 1 by R equivalent is simply 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. And you can take this the ratio of this two equation, this equation 3.11.8 and 3.11.9, and you can easily find out E by R. This is E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2. So if the EMFs of two cells are E1, E2, if you say that they are equal and R1, R2 are also R, we simply get E, this EMF equivalent will be equal to E, means total of this, and R equivalent will be simply R by 2. Okay, so we have joined, I'll just show you some more figure regarding this. And here what we have done, see, we have joined the positive terminal at point A, and similarly the, if you see the two negative plates at point B, so the current I1 and I2 flow through the positive terminal. But if the negative terminal of the second is connected to positive terminal to the first, right? This is a scenario, but I'm just saying that we are just changing. I just want to reverse the polarity. Then we would still get E2 only, as we just have to put E2 equal to minus E2, right? Because the situation is like this. If you convert it like this, right? So only the EMF will be negative, because ultimately what we have done is we have followed the Kirchhoff rule, and if we just change the polarity, it will be according to that. So if there are n cells of EMF E1, E2 and EN, and internal resistance are R1 to Rn, their connection in parallel, the combination is equivalent to a single cell which has EMF which is equivalent and internal resistance is R equivalent. So 1 by R equivalent is given by 1 by R, 1 by R2 till 1 by Rn. And if you have already seen that E equivalent by R equivalent is given by E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2, and I was given by sigma EI by Ri 1 plus R sigma 1 by Ri. I varies from 1 to n, here also 1 to n. So if n cells of EMF E1 to En resistances are from Rn, internal resistance, they are connected in series to form a row, and we have m such row. So if we have one row, like if we have certain n rows, there are n here, and we have from this point to this point, we have m such rows. They are connected in parallel. These are in series, n are in series, and we have m such rows. These are in series. These are in series. So we have m such rows. If this kind of connection is there, this is a mixed combination, then I will be equivalent to sigma, this EI, R plus 1 by M, sigma RI. This capital R is the external resistance across this mixed form of connection, because we have series also, this series, and these series, they are in parallel. So, they are number of parallel lines like this. So, what will be the equivalent? Equivalent, the current passing through will be this value. M is the number of rows, N is the number of cells in a row. And of course, R is the external resistance which is connected to the mixed connection. In the circuit which is shown here, E1 is equal to 3 volt, E2 is equal to 2 volt, and E3 is 1 volt. The resistance R1, R2, R3, they are 1 ohm. Find the current through each branch and potential difference between the point A and B. So in this case, let us assume that this I is passing through, from A to B is passing through. Now I1, I2 and I3, this I1, see the directions are like this. I1 is this current, I2 is this current, and I3 is this current. Okay. From the Kirchhoff law, if you take this point, I1 will be equal to I2 plus I3. Okay, and the I1, I2, I3 are there. Resistances are R1, R2, and R3. Now, first we have applied a junction rule, Kirchhoff first rule to junction A. This junction A says that the current is going from this, at this point, current is coming here. One current is coming and two currents are leaving. So I1 will be equal to I2 plus I3. This is our first equation. Now we'll apply the Kirchhoff second rule to loops. First we'll take the loop as A and then B. You can take B and C and D, and then you can take E and F and A. So complete one we are taking, right? So if we take I1, R1, we are moving in this direction. So there will be, or you can say, let us move in ABC direction. So let us move in this direction. So now we are in opposite direction. So there will be a I1, R1 addition. Then because this is positive to negative, there is a drop. But the drop will be taken as minus E1. And then we are coming here. It is increasing. So minus to positive will be positive. And once you are in the opposite direction, you have to add it, right? And we can just rearrange, and you will get this one. But we can take one more loop, which is ABCDEFA. ABCDA you can take ABCDA. This whole you can take one, and this whole you can take, right? So from both these we get the second one, I1 R1 minus, because now E1 and E3 are coming. So E1 E3 was this one which I explained you. Now E1 and E2 you can also take. It will be similar, I1 R1 then E1, because the voltage is dropping, and then it is increasing, so E2, and then there is an increment of I2 R2 because you are in the opposite direction. So it will be like this. So when we combine these two equations, this E1 minus R1 will be equal to E2 plus IR2 will be equal to E3 plus IR3, and we know that I1 was equal to I2 plus I3. This was our first junction equation. So after this 3 and 4, if you see E1 minus, in this I1, you can write I2 plus I3. So we have placed I2 plus I3 here, and this remains here. So you get 2 I3 plus I2 equal to 2. Also, we can use this to second equation. So you get E2 plus I2 R2 equal to E3 plus I3 R3. And you can just say, rearranging this, you get I3 minus I2 equal to 1. So you have one this equation, second this equation, so, and one more equation like this. So you can just solve I1, I2 and I3. I1 is 1 ampere, I2 is 0 ampere, I3 is 1 ampere, right? This is how we can find out the current. Now, potential difference between A and B will be what? The potential difference between A and B is simply potential difference between A and D. These are same, right? So the potential difference between A and D is given by, this is, see, E1 minus I1 R1. We are taking this path. So E1 minus I R1, you can take this also. No worries about that. You can take this also. Any of these you can take. Minus I1 R1. So E1 is 3. I1 we just found out as 1 ampere, and R1 this resistance is 1. So this is 2 volt.